Ladies and gentlemen,
you are listening to Young Men's Perspective Radio.
Live on Iliad, we are Real Baby Media.
We look to enrich, encourage, and engage our youth here on iHeartRadio.
And it's presented like a jewel.
We interview individuals such as Susan L. Taylor.
What we know is that failing schools are the pipeline to prison.
Jasari X.
We're the changers, and I feel like this generation is a generation that's really going to make change.
Dr. Julia Hare.
The best part of our action plan is to reclaim the minds of our children.
Dick Gregory.
Our plan is we think we're part of this government, you know.
This is Young Men's Perspective Radio.
Live on Iliad, we are Real Baby Media.
Tune in to WWRN 1100 AM on Wednesdays from 3 to 4 p.m. and every Friday from 10 to 11 p.m. on WWE 1100 AM on iHeartRadio.
Just gotta get in tune with your purpose.
YMP.
You know.
Your calling number is
404-603-8770.
No.
Your host, Jeff.
We here now
with your co-host, Digger Dame Lee.
Young Men's Perspective Radio.
Young Men's Perspective Radio.
YMP.
Welcome to the future, baby.
Yo, what's up? This is the Kid Capri. People all over the world!
It's official.
You're listening to the hottest internet station.
YMP.
Young Men's Perspective Radio.
Live on Iliad. We are Real Baby Media.
On iHeartRadio.
I love this station.
YMP.
What's going on? What's going on? We are in the building. This is your host, Jeff Hodges.
And it's your man's. Live on LEF, Digger Dame Lee.
What's going on tonight, everybody? We glad to be back on the air. We glad y'all joined us. Definitely appreciate the love and support you're showing on social media. Definitely follow us on Instagram at YMP1, and definitely follow us on Twitter at YMP Mag Magazine. Definitely keep up with us and see what's going on. What's going on today, people?
Peace, peace, peace. What it do, everybody? Live on LEF, we are Real Fake Media. We're an international household name.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Indeed,
yes,
like
sir.
I said, it's your man's Digger Dame Lee, a.k.a. the guy with the bionic eye. And here we are in our second week. Mr. Hodges, kind sir, tell me how you're feeling about this right now. We got a pretty good turnout the first round.
Yes, sir.
How you feeling now?
Yes, sir. Nah, I'm feeling really great. Feeling really great. It's definitely a good look, all the love, again, that they're showing and the support. We definitely appreciate it on this side over here. And we got a great lineup for you tonight. Real excited about tonight's show. We got a special guest calling in, a good friend and someone I'm definitely a supporter of, and I am a fan. We got C.R. CAPERS going to be calling in tonight, y'all.
C.R. CAPERS.
Yeah. Harlem World.
All right.
She the founder of that hip-hop festival, New York City, up there doing her thing. Also, she got that that podcast, Why You Mad, Son. We going to definitely get it in tonight with that. And also, we just got to make an announcement. We know we had Dick Gregory coming in the building. And because we caught him on the last minute, we kind of caught him as soon as we heard he was in town. We connected.
Right.
The schedules kind of clashed, but that didn't go down like we planned. But nevertheless, we're still in the building because we got that kind of love, you know? So we're going to be doing it on a visual note. My people's right here. Digger Dan going to hold us down on that note. And we're going to sit down with the doctor tomorrow. And we'll have that for you guys. Like I said, follow us on our social media. That'll be on all our sites. And you can definitely check out as we sit down with Dr. Dick Gregory and bring you that great information like always.
Yes, yes. So just keep that in mind. We will be with the great Dr. Dick Gregory. Manana. You know what I mean? We just had to respect the schedule. So we do have this beautiful guest that's going to be calling in. And I'm kind of excited because me being part of the hip-hop culture and basically growing with that whole concept, you dig? I'm inspired by this lady's energy that she's been able to cultivate. You know what I mean?
Yeah, now I see y'all. Boogie definitely been doing her thing for a long time. She and a few others that are definitely been in a little small circle watching the growth. And as I said, being a fan and just can't wait to learn so much more about what she's doing with this newfounded project that they kicked off in 2016. And they're doing real big things. So, yeah, real excited about that as well.
Respect. So, we're looking for some callers to call in just to say what's up again. Again, this is our second week. And also, as we acknowledged our first week, we're looking for those sponsorships, yo.
Definitely.
We want y'all to rock with us, get involved, allow us to help your brand, cultivate your company, push this energy through this pipeline that we are so honorable to be able to have access to. Thank you to Worldwide Radio Network, the Beasley Group, and iHeartRadio, you know what I mean?
Yes, so, sir. Yes, sir.
With that, we want y'all to help keep this in motion, you know what I mean? This is our moment, you dig what I'm saying? We get this avenue, this platform to bring y'all good energy, great interviews, you know what I mean? Things of that nature, you know what I mean?
For sure. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So as we said also on the last segment, we told y'all we're going to be dropping that Young Men's Perspective next edition, edition 6. We're real excited about that.
Yes,
got
sir.
Some great stories in there. I don't know if y'all seen it. I really do believe you have. But my little nephew, Major, shout out to you, my little dude. Did his thing, went viral, dancing to that OT Genesis,
oh, yeah,
Push It.
Oh, yeah, nephew,
you know.
Cold-blooded.
Yes, sir.
That.
So we're going to drop an article in there about that, you know. Show you what a light can do, because you know he definitely did some major moves with that.
Doesn't he have his own clothes line?
What, man, we gonna tell y'all all about
okay,
it. He got
okay.
That clothing line, got that sit down interview with that Angie Martinez. Now he made major moves. So
major
shout out
moves.
To my little great nephew, you know.
I like it.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I know it's around that time, if I'm not mistaken, man.
Yeah, we should be getting a little ring soon.
We should
and,
be chit-chatting with somebody very valuable in just a moment, man.
Indeed.
But for those of you that do want to call in, just to say what up, the number is 404-603-8770. Again, that's 404-603-8770. Zero.
Yeah, you
give us a call. Say what's up.
Indeed. You're listening to Young Men's Perspective Radio. I'm your host, Jeff Hodges.
And I'm your man's Digger Dame Lee, a.k.a. Poppy Rossi.
So we're going to be getting it in real soon with our peoples. Like we said, we're looking forward to chop it up. Let y'all know what's that all about. All you filmmakers out there, y'all better listen up. Get a jewel or two. You're going to learn how to get down and do this and keep them cultivating that hip-hop, you know? So definitely stay tuned as we bring it to y'all live here on Illy Ave.
So let me ask you something. Our engineer Rick out there. Yo, Rick, how you feeling right now, man? This is our second week together. How's it feeling over here? Uh-oh, I think we got a caller, ladies and gentlemen. The guy is in motion. That's the engineer at work right there. That's our family, Rick. And I want to give a shout-out to Diamond Life.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
it's very
yeah,
important
yeah.
that we give a shout-out to the lady with the golden voice. Here we go. Let's see Rick over there, engineer.
All right, so we got a call on the line. What's your name, caller?
Hey, fellas. This is Brooklyn's son. How y'all doing?
Hey, Brooklyn's what's going on,
son.
Brooklyn?
I didn't get to listen last week, so I just wanted to make sure I listened this week and called in. And so, y'all, congratulations and welcome again.
We appreciate it. We appreciate it.
You
know,
I feel so comfortable sitting here in this blessed seat that you've anointed. So, thank you so very much for again your energy and your love and your light. So, thank you for that.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Y'all have a great evening, and I'll be tuned in. Okay.
We appreciate it.
All right, love.
One love, future.
Right now, on deck, as we've been waiting and anticipating, it's that
right
writer,
now.
Producer, radio personality, director, distributor of independent film, film festival coordinator, lover of hip-hop culture. You want to know who's in the building?
Who's in the building?
C.R. Boogie is on deck.
Boogie! Hey, what's up, y'all?
Mom's in the house. All right.
You and the brothers in the house.
How you been, C.R.?
I'm doing good. It's finally great to be on air with you. Absolutely. I have been waiting for this all week.
Okay. Well, I'm definitely excited to have you. As I said early on, you know, we definitely come from an era. I know for me, that was like the beginning there on Blog Talk when we did our thing in 2008 and kind of linked up and kind of watched and followed you grow and doing your thing with Why You Mad Son, the podcast. As I was telling my people, y'all was banging out.
Respect.
Yeah, man, we was. We had it on lock for a minute.
Yes, sir. So today we want to definitely get it in for all these film and documentary makers who are cultivating hip-hop via the visual unit and talk about the hip-hop film festival that you founded back in 2016, you and your squad. Tell us all about that.
Well, the hip-hop film festival, you know, we trying to keep the culture alive. And one of the most important mediums that we have to tell our stories, change narratives, and push through new stories is through film. It's also a way of preserving our history, and that's so important for the hip-hop nation, so important for the hip-hop culture. So, you know, we said we was getting into film after, you know, while doing our radio podcast, we got into film, shooting commercials and stuff, and then, you know, we took a look at the industry and said, you know, how can we push forward narratives and help other people do the same thing? You know, we all about that community work. So the festival was born, and we said, you know, hey, let's do it. Now, when we first started it, it was we figured it would be like 50 of our friends, you know, close, because we didn't know exactly how it would grow. But it popped off. We had over 3,000 people come out from all over the world. It was a banger, and it worked. And we call it the Hip Hop Film Festival, but it's about the culture of hip hop. So we focus on directors, producers, and writers who grew up in the culture.
Right.
So the films don't necessarily have to have a hip hop element in it. You just need to have come from the generation and be a filmmaker. And that's what was missing in the space. So we filled the space with it, created a blue ocean.
Indeed. And I also see that on deck you got Uncle Ralph McDaniels from back in the day's Video Music Box as a strong supporter and a part of your platform as well. Tell us how that came about and what role he's playing.
Well, Uncle Ralph, he and I had known each other from way back. We worked on a bunch of projects. And when I started the festival, I went to him and I said, hey, listen, you know, in order for us to make sure it's not taken from us, we need to be grounded in the roots of it. So let's you know, bring you on as the chairman for the first year and, you know, help us develop it as far as, you know, giving us ideas and giving us that star power that we needed locally to get things in motion. And he did that. You know, he's been a great, he's a legendary force when you talk about the combination of hip-hop film and putting narratives on screen. He's launched a lot of careers. So it only made sense to have him be the chairman for the first year, for the breakout year of the festival. So, yeah. That's how that all went down.
So let me ask you this, CR.
Mm-hmm.
You getting involved with this in an international level.
Yes.
How beneficial do you find that the culture has spread in such a manner? Like, how beneficial do you find this particular platform for the international palette?
Mm. I find that it is, when we talk about the culture of hip-hop, it's universal. So one of the things that my team and I found out is that the way we think about ourselves, the hip-hop nation, the people that started it, and the way it is now marketed to us here in America is completely different than the way it's seen internationally. We had films come in from all over the world. I'm talking about the furthest reaches, places you wouldn't even think about it. And what they did, it was such an homage to Black American culture, to the culture period, and to giving voice to the voiceless. A lot of the young people that are doing films now, they grew up in hip-hop too, because they might have come from a disenfranchised area in Germany or Ireland or Poland or Israel or Palestine. And all of these places is where I'm telling you we got films from. And it was all the same, whether it was whether they were doing a film about you know, a street film, or whether it was a hip-hop element involved in the film, it was all the same. They really preserved the culture. You found none of the gangster stuff, none of the negative connotations that is marketed to us, the creators, which is crazy to me. But it was a learning lesson, and it showed the humanity, like how we're all connected through this one genre. And it's amazing. Amazing to see the growth.
That's an awesome, awesome awareness that you've taken to that, because I can recall being in the Fiji Islands, and they thought that every black person in the States was like the guy from Police Academy. They thought that we all
right.
So this is how they thought we communicated, right, for real, right, that we right. just made
right.
So right. Me being an MC over there and having a chance to tap into the nectar, the culture, you know what I mean, the appreciation that I did receive, you know what I'm saying, without it having to be vulgar or whatnot. So I can relate to exactly what you're saying there. So I applaud you for creativity.
So tell us. It was amazing the amount of support that we got locally and internationally, from the press to, there's this huge festival that happens in Harlem. It's called Harlem Week. Usually, it runs all summer. It's been going on for over 30 years. And they designated us as the official competition film festival. So that brought in mega press. We also won Best Festival in the United States.
Yeah.
In 2016, Quentin Tarantino was on deck. That was crazy and surreal for us, because, you know, when you start something, you want it to be successful.
Right.
But when it happens, it's like, holy crap.
Okay.
Wow. Oh, my God. We did it. Mama, we made it.
Right.
So it was just a great experience. And the love that we got from filmmakers from all over the world, and still to this day get, is amazing. As we go into our 2017 season, we have even more submissions and even more harder decisions to make when it comes to that.
Let's talk about the process to accepting submissions, and what is the protocol, right, so people can have an idea when they get ready to get that work to you.
Well, first of all, let me say that we're now taking submissions. Our submissions deadline is May 15th. We extended it a little bit because we're having so much response. We extended it a little bit longer than it was last year. But the process is this. Basically, there's 4 points to filmmaking that I say that to pass muster and to get to the judging panel. One is sound. Your sound must be correct. If I can't hear what you're saying, if I don't understand, it's too loud, too low, if there's anything wrong, it's a wrap. That's number one. So the second is cinematography. You know, is it beautiful? Is it clear? Can we see it? Is it in focus? Are your shots lined up right? So on and so forth. The third is casting. And that's kind of threefold, because that involves the actors themselves, that involves wardrobe, and it just involves, you know, just the talent of how it was put together, you know, and how the cast plays off each other, because you have a character. If your sound is right and your cinematography is good, but your actors can't act, or you got a slave running around with a flat top, it's a problem. You know? It's a problem. And we've had that. So that's a problem. The last criteria is the story itself. Is it original? Does it make you think? If it's not an original story, because we all share common human interests, is it compelling? Is it told in a way that represents the time that we are in? Does it have a message? Or if it doesn't have a message, is it just a good story? So those are the four elements. And if you meet those criteria, regardless of who you are or where you come from, whether you're high post or just starting out, you get in and you pass on to the judges. So that's how it works. We've had celebrities come to us with projects and didn't pass the four criteria.
Wow.
They're out of here.
Wow.
Yeah. They weren't happy about that, but we want to change the mold. We're not, you know, one of these scam festivals where we're just taking people's money. If you don't get in, we tell you why you don't get in. What element out of the four were you missing? We give you a chance to correct it, and we say, listen, come, if you fix that, come back next year. Your fee is waived. Let's try it again. So we're really about supporting the filmmakers, helping them with distribution deals, helping them with their marketing. We share our profits with the filmmakers that are selected to participate.
Mm.
So this is more than just some, you know, a film festival where people go just to be seen. This is about supporting narratives, not only by screening it, but also providing the tools that they can progress financially. And that's really what's needed right now.
Let me ask you this, CR. Me being a mm-hmm. visual language expressor.
yes.
What encouraged you to really go this route out of all the other aspects of hip hop that you could have delved into? What made you decide to go this route, the visual route? Like, how did you come into that frequency?
Two things. Appropriation is one. I saw something that was created for the people and by the people being co-opted by corporate interests. Mm. And there was no one speaking out in the space or offering opportunity in the space where real stories can be heard and can grow. The second one is what our motto is, change to change the narrative, bring a revolution of the mind. Like you said, when you went, you know, overseas, they'd only saw one image of us, and that's not us. You know, they take a character from a movie, and then that's it. So if that's the medium that people are learning about other people, then we need to begin to change that narrative and provide more options so that we can show that we are more than just this caricature of, you know, what some white man dreamed up in a studio office one day.
Right.
You know, not all of us are running around wearing dresses or, exactly. you know, doing drive-bys.
Exactly.
You know, we're science fiction, we're mystery, we're all of these things, horror, romance.
I was going to ask you that. What is your sci-fi arena like in this particular vibration of expression? Like, what is the sci-fi portion like?
The sci-fi is off the chain. The yeah. submissions that we got last year and this year, I mean, we got black folks doing, you know, flips and special effects, and just it's just amazing. And it's on par with what we're seeing out there now.
Okay.
You know, I've seen, you know, interpretations of black superheroes. Mm. There was one with a little boy that was a superhero. I mean, it was amazing. And you also have thinking pieces, too, that remind you of the Twilight Zone that touches the sci-fi modality right. there.
Okay.
So, you know, we have all these stories, but we never get to see it.
Talk about the importance, as you know, in regards to controlling and being able to tell our stories and having these type of platforms.
I'm glad you said that key word, which is controlling it. One of the things that we have learned from our legends in music is always control your masters. Own your masters. Because once someone else owns it, they can change it, mm-hmm. and then they can appropriate it and change the characters and do whatever they want to do with it. So it is very important that we maintain ownership, even when we go into distribution deals. I know a lot of filmmakers, they figure, you know, hey, let me get this check. Y'all can do whatever the hell y'all want with the story.
Right.
But we try to impress upon them that this is about more than a check,
right.
way more than a check. This is about telling a story and being in control of that story,
mm-hmm.
so it's not shifted, watered down, or taken out of context. Because if you're putting something out there for the larger world to look at, that's something that they are going to learn from. So it is very important that we maintain ownership, even through our distribution deals. No one should have creative control of anything that you put out as a filmmaker, just you.
I applaud you for that. You know what I mean? Just the integrity of even being that aware. You dig? Like, we applaud you over here, Young Men's Perspective Radio. This is awesome to receive. And like, I want to know how to help you, help me, help us. Like, how do we get this word out more? Like, give us more information on how to contact you and things of that nature, because I want people to understand, and I want them to hear it repeated before you escape us for this brief moment. You know what I mean? I want them to understand
right.
that we can change what it is that we've been taught to experience as long as we control how we see the experience. You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And you having okay. that platform, like, it's only right that the visual voice is a part of that. So how can people contact you?
Well, thank you. Well, first of all, they can go to our website at hiphopfilmfestival.org. Again, that's hiphopfilmfestival.org. You can contact us through there. We're taking submissions through Film Freeway, which is a huge platform for accredited film festivals. You can find us on Facebook at Hip Hop Film Festival NYC and on Instagram at Hip Hop Film Fest NYC. We're very approachable, relatable. Our whole team is there. Or find me on Facebook, CR Capers. Send me a message. We are here in service of our community. And we've always been like that. You know how the Mad Men rock. We've been doing since the slave ships. So, you know, putting this together, it was the next step in our progression. And this year, we're really blasting it out. We're going to bring in more films. We even have this year, last year we had a virtual reality lounge, and this year we're expanding it out to 3,000 square feet, tech exhibit, we call it, of virtual reality, interactive experience. Wow. Immersive storytelling, gaming. You can come get your game on. We have some filmmakers that did virtual reality films. You can actually, you know, watch a film in virtual reality. Wow. One of the featured films that we have in competition is on the Legendary Cypher. So it's going to be dope, man. It's going to be dope.
These are melanated filmmakers, you say?
These are all, well, actually, you know what? Yes, it is melanated filmmakers, but it's also filmmakers from all over the world.
Right.
Like this year, we have Israel participating. We have Pakistan participating. We got a film from Iraq.
Wow. Okay.
Middle East is repping heavy. We got submissions from Poland. We got submissions from Denmark. We got submissions from South Africa. You name it. Every single continent has submitted. Wow. So, yeah, so, you know, when it comes down to picking the film, it's hard to say. We don't even look at who the director is or who made it. We look at the film, and we base it on that criteria because we don't want any discrimination, because when it comes to hip-hop and the culture, it's always been a culture of inclusion and collaboration.
Indeed.
So, and this is a world, this festival is a world, it's truly a world collaboration.
So let me ask you this question real quick. How long does the films have to be? Are there short films? Is it feature films? Is it 30-minute, you know what I mean, little situations? Mm-hmm. How does the timing or the length of the films go?
It runs the whole gamut. So our shorts are up to 30, can be, you know, up to 45 minutes, I believe. We also do web series. Those can be anywhere from 30 minutes to an hour. Feature films, 90 minutes. Feature documentaries are 90 minutes. Animation, depending on if it's a short or feature, 45 to 60 minutes. You know. And we do music videos as well. Okay. So your music video is considered a short, and that can be anywhere from 3 minutes to a half hour.
Wow.
Okay. Well, I want you to stay tuned.
So basically, we take everything. We consider everything.
We're going to definitely get into everything. So hold tight for me, Boogie. Y'all listen up. We get ready to take a commercial break real quick, pay these bills, and we'll be right back. You listening to Young Men's Perspective Radio.
Welcome to the future, baby.
Back.
Young Men's Perspective
Radio.
Your call in number is
404-603-8770. That's 404-603-8770. Call in now.
You're here now.
On iHeartRadio.
Yeah. Live from the 718. DJ Clue. Desert Storm. With the Hard Knock Life soundtrack. We're taking y'all backstage. Holla.
I'm focused, man. Tell Stout to holla at me, man. Young Hova, you heard?
New Maya.
Trackman, you heard?
Yeah.
Yawling, Jigga Man be ballin', these chicks pigeon toed, some of them be crawling. Get the best of you whenever I put my all in. Have mommies calling for the law, darling. Jigga ain't calling. Drop coops with half the top, expose half my knot. Mad when I brag about the cash I got, but I'm used to not having a lot. I'm from the gutter and I ain't the type to ever chase your. I'm the type to interior decorate the watch. I'm the type to sling heavy the block in every state like clock. Word jiggers to hurt, holla.
Your lips are telling me yes. While you're kissing me on my neck, making me feel so. Should I stay? Should I go? I don't know.
Want to fly somewhere? Looking for cheap flights or cheap tickets? Then call
That's right. Call the low-cost airline travel hotline now for prices so low, we can't publish them anywhere. Low-cost airlines has all kinds of cheap travel deals. Fly domestically and save up to 75%. You can even fly internationally and save even more. Yes, fly anywhere in the world and save a lot of money on your plane tickets. We'll even save you money with cheap travel deals on hotels, rental cars, even complete travel packages. So don't book your tickets until you call us first for the absolute cheapest prices on U.S. and international airline tickets and hotels. Call right now for prices so low they can't be published. Travel experts are here 24/7 to help. 800-719-5601. 800-719-5601. 800-719-5601. That's 800-719-5601.
There's a lot going on in the world,
and your world is always changing.
That's why it's important to stay connected.
The latest news, the latest entertainment, the newest music. If it's in the air
or
on the air,
it can be in the palm of your hand,
wherever you are,
with the iHeartRadio app.
iHeartRadio.
Over 1,500 live radio stations from across the country and over 15 million songs to create your own custom stations. Text IHR to 45495 to download the app or listen at iHeartRadio.com. Standard text and data rates apply.
Tune your radio.
Tune in.
Now.
You can tune in to this radio station on any smartphone or tablet.
iPhone.
Android.
BlackBerry.
Nokia.
Samsung.
Windows phones.
Or whatever you have. Download the free TuneIn app from your phone or tablet's app store.
Tune in with music, sports, news, and comedy.
From over 70,000 radio stations around the world, including this Beasley Broadcast Group station. Check it out at TuneIn.com.
Or your app store.
I'm starting off like this. Mr. Derry, man, this is the legendary, the cool, the DJ, the red alert. And all I got to say is one thing right now. Ask Donna.
You are listening to Young Men's Perspective Radio.
Live on Iliad, we are Real Baby Me.
On iHeartRadio.
We here now.
YMP.
Yeah, we back. Thank you all for listening and sitting tight and joining the show, I hope. And on the phone, we got our special guest, C.R. CAPERS, founder of the Hip Hop Film Festival. We getting it in, chopping it up. CAPERS, you're still there, I know, right?
I'm still here. You already know.
All right. So talk about that festival that's kicking off in August and what people can anticipate when it's going to go down.
That's right. So August 3rd through the 6th, New York City, we locking down the city. We're at the National Black Theater. That's on 125th and 5th Avenue. It's in the Mecca. So we're doing it big. So it's 4 days of fresh, as we call it. So in addition to all the screenings, we have our featured pieces, our opening film, which is a film all the way from France called Swagger. Mm. We have our spotlight films. I'm going to leave that as a surprise.
No doubt.
And we have our closing film. Remember Kid and Play, right?
Yeah, right.
I remember Kid and Play. Christopher Martin,
right.
He's also a filmmaker, and he's dropping a film that he's been working on for the past 7 to 10 years called And I Dance.
Mm, okay.
So he's going to be in the building premiering his film. So we got some really dope stuff coming for you. In addition with the Techzibit Lounge, again, it's 3,000 square feet of technology, virtual reality, gaming mm-hmm. for everybody. We got free beer on deck all 4 days.
You said free beer?
Free beer on deck all 4 days.
Okay.
We got DJ lounges from top to bottom, so when you come in, it's just such a welcoming feeling when you come in, hearing the music, you know, vibing with everybody. It's great networking opportunity. We also have our master classes, which are going to be led by some of the some great people in the industry, some very well-known, some starting. We've got a great mix. And our master classes cover everything from the art of the distribution deal to the art of sound, or the art of the score. You know, for people who are scoring, and that's great for hip-hop artists who want to get their music into movies.
Right.
One of the things I always tell people is that there should be no poverty. One of the biggest money makers in this country is the entertainment field.
Yes.
So when the auto industry left, you had this hole. But what people don't realize is that the entertainment industry is the next, is where the next middle class is. And for some reason, we're not being taught how to be gaffers. We're not being taught how to be electricians on set, principal photographers, camera people.
Right.
These guys is making over $100,000 a year.
Grips.
Or out the gate.
Yes.
So these things need to be taught. So these are the things that the masterclass is focused on, letting people know that these opportunities exist and connecting them with the people who can get them those jobs. So it's about more than just the films. It's also about the industry and how we can lift ourselves up economically to change narratives and to stay employed as well. So we also have a launch party, closing party, award ceremony. Everything that you would get in a big festival, we got it. But we do it with flavor.
Wow, it sounds delectably incredible, you know what I mean? Especially just for us that's from the cloth, you know what I mean? That didn't grow up off of hip-hop, but grew up with hip-hop, the transition of the whole concept when it was being doubted that it was even going to have legs on it, you know what I mean? So just to hear this is like really dope, because I know a lot of people, especially just in our personal team, that's gotten involved with camera works, the visual language of it all, you know, going back to the digital, to right now I call it the digital hieroglyphs, you know what I mean? Like,
yes.
I might just have to tag that real quick. That might be a new company. Let's hold on to that one. We're gonna
trademark.
Yeah, trademark copyright. We got that right now. We got that, CR. We got that. The capers. You dig? The capers. We're protected. It's been said. But no, I really want to applaud you just for how this is translating, you dig? And I'm hoping that the people that's out there listening right now on Young Men's Perspective Radio, that's out there having an opportunity live on Illy Ave to witness the power of what you're saying, you dig?
Right.
So,
I want to let you guys know so much to this festival, way so much. We also have, this year, we introduced the Screenwriters Contest.
Okay.
And it is sponsored by Final Draft. Final Draft is what Hollywood uses to create their scripts. It's what everybody uses in the industry. Multi-million dollar films use this software. So they've come on board to support our filmmakers and said, hey, listen, this is part of the prize for that. Inktip has also joined in on the Screenwriters Contest. Inktip is where your screenplay, they take it and they give it to agents to look and see, so people could get real jobs writing for TV and movies through this contest. We also giving away $2,500 in cash. You get a script consultation. You get paid entry into Final Draft's Big Break contest. You get an Apple iPad. So it's dope. It's dope. It's so much involved in this festival. You really got to get to the website, get all the information. We're taking volunteers. If you want to work for the festival, we got openings. We're taking we're signing up volunteers until the 15th of this month. We got a couple of days.
Right.
Wait, what's today? We got till tomorrow, actually.
Okay.
Sign up. Got till tomorrow to sign up. It's dope. It's dope.
All right. So now here's another question. Here's another question. The way that the films are being done.
Yes.
Is it possible that you're going to grow into your own, like, distribution company? Are you already that, or is this something that you're aiming to become, like, a distributor of all this content that you're gathering?
I'm glad you asked that question. You know, with Why You Mad Son, and when we started Revolution Media, you know, we started doing our own films. We formed a distribution company as well to push our own products. With the film festival, we decided to take another angle. We decided to begin our own streaming service, which is Hip Hop Film Festival TV.
Okay.
So everybody that's in the festival gets put on the streaming service, and they get paid. Get a monthly check just for being on it. And it's, you don't have to, there's no point system, no how many times did somebody watch it. It's, you know, so somebody subscribes to it, it's $5 a month. The filmmakers that are on the platform, we share it out equally.
Okay.
There's no catch, no gimmick. It's just straightforward. So that content lives on the site, on the streaming service, which is like a hip-hop Netflix, if you will.
Wow.
It lives there, for the duration of the festival season, and then, you know, each year it'll change with each new crop of filmmakers.
All right, that's powerful. So do me a favor. Do me one more favor. Can you? Am I allowed to ask you for a favor so soon in our relationship?
Of course, of course.
Please tell
the
people.
I'm here to serve.
Let me find out. Tell the people how to get at you again, because it sounds too expensive right now, and I hear you working with it. But tell them how to get at you again, please, C.R.
Again, you can reach me at hiphopfilmfestival.org. Let me give you guys the number to the off as well.
We done made an upgrade, baby.
Live and direct. You call our offices and we'll hook you up. The telephone number to the Hip Hop Film Festival is 347-574-0700. Again, that's 347-574-0700.
Now listen, I know for a fact that all of this that you experienced has to be so surreal. Share with my listeners that moment. Like, what is that moment you've had? It was like, wow.
Wow, there were so many. It was when the response was like, wow. Then when we started the festival and opened the doors, we're looking outside, you know, whenever you give an event, you're like, oh my God, nobody's going to come, even right. though you got tickets sold or whatever. We look outside and there's a line down the street. That was crazy to me. The way people came in and just would hug me and be like, thank you. And I'm like, no, thank you. That was surreal. Quentin Tarantino coming over to me and being like, yo, this is probably one of the most important festivals created. That was surreal because he's one of my favorite directors. My top three is Quentin, Spike, and J.J. Abrams. That was surreal. That was surreal. So many. I even now, it's surreal. Being on the air talking with you guys about it, it's surreal.
Welcome
to the future, baby. This is awesome for me to hear and share, because I put a lot of time in out in the Hollywood arena, and had I've been able to vibrate towards the development of this early on, man. I'm sure, I'll be able to speak about this totally different. But now that I'm hearing about it, I'm able to share it. There's a platform that people are able to receive it here on Young Men's Perspective Radio. So it's like, we thank you, man. Like, wow, this is really fly.
And thank you guys so much. And I gotta shout out my team, my executive team. Indeed. We got 10 people. I mean, the way they throw themselves into this festival, volunteering, because none of us get paid to do this. We do this on the strength.
Wow.
The festival pays for itself. But we do this for the love, and my team is the best team ever. One of our newest team members is...
I said, talk to us then.
One of our newest team members was actually a filmmaker who participated last year. He came to me and he said, yo, Sha, I have this idea for an Urban Web Summit. You know, can you help? I said, yeah, let's do it. This is your dream. You're one of our babies. You're one of our filmmakers. Let's do it. Let's incubate it. So now all of our web series is being funneled through the Urban Web Summit to help him grow his business and get his wings as a festival creator and developer. So when if you look up urbanwebsummit.com, you know, you'll see he got it popping, and he has got a lot of dope series on deck that are participating, and all of those get awards, and whoever wins in that category, they shoe on over to our festival for the big prizes.
Okay, and that's Urban Web Summit?
Yes, urbanwebsummit.com.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to have to check that out, too.
Yes. One big family.
This is awesome. So your advertisement, how do y'all go about doing it with the type of film directors and things that you're having? Like, how's your commercial platform as far as your campaigns and things of that nature?
Well, we really created a blue ocean with this, with the popularity of YU Mass on radio and our reach. When we said that, you know, we were doing films, people supported. When we came out and said, hey, we're going to do it at the film festival, people supported. And that's how we grew it. We leveraged our social media connections to grow this festival, and that's what we did. As we grew bigger, you know, the larger media entities came on board. But we also do strategic partnerships with radio shows like yourself. We had the Daily News. This year we have CBS Radio, 1010 Wins. A plethora of bloggers and podcasters who are spreading the word. We use social media influencers to help us spread the word. So it's very grassroots in its growth, but I think it's the best way to grow something. Well, you know, it's
if that
underground feel.
If I may share with you, since we are live on Iliab at the moment, I noticed that Brooklyn Sun, she's also one of the gifts here at the radio station. She wants to be a volunteer. I know that that's fact because she just told me so. So now I'm telling you so. And it's only right that we bring this over here to Illy Avenue. I mean, we got to set up shop on Illy Ave. So we won't talk. We're going to talk about this all the time, every time. This is real life, real time, baby.
Yes, tell her to come on. Everybody is needed. This is a true collaboration, and everybody brings skill set and knowledge to what we're doing. We listen to everyone's ideas. Everyone's ideas is just as important as mine and the team's. So our volunteers were very instrumental in developing our festival. Wow. You know, and all of them are coming back this year. They love this so much, and we love them. We couldn't do it without our volunteers. So tell her to come on.
Indeed. Ain't nothing like hip-hop music. We're going to kick right. Okay, going to pay these bills real quick. Sit tight for us, CR. We're going to get you to give that close-out word before we shut it down. We're going to take a commercial break, and we'll be right back. You're listening to Young Men's Perspective Radio.
Hi.
Check this out. We're online.
On 1100Atlanta.com.
Right here.
On 1100Atlanta.com.
On iHeartRadio.
I love you, love you. I love you guys.
My melody, hand out a cigar. I'm letting knowledge be born, and my name's the R. A.K.A. I am not like the rest of them. I'm not on the list. That's what I'm saying. I drop lines like a scientist. My melody's in the code. The very next episode has the mic off and distorting, ready to explode. I keep the mic at Fahrenheit. Freedom seeds to make them cola. The listener's system is kicking like solar. As I memorize, advertise like a poet. Keep you going when the flow is smooth enough. You know it, but rough. That's why the mural on my story, I tell a B. Nobody beats the R. Check out my melody.
This is a national health alert from the 24/7 Diabetic Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one has diabetes, listen closely. Now, regardless of your age, if you have insurance, you may qualify to receive diabetic testing supplies with little to no out-of-pocket cost. Get free delivery, free information, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers for free. Call the 24/7 Diabetic Health Hotline now for details. But wait, there's more. If you call right now, you could get a free meter upgrade. In addition, we'll give you a free pedometer as our special gift to you. We have knee, back, and other braces available, as well as pharmacy services. Regardless of your age, if you suffer with diabetes and you have insurance, we can help.
800-590-1164. 800-590-1164. 800-590-1164. That's 800-590-1164.
Dad, I'm really afraid of what's happening with the economy. There's too much civil unrest, too much terrorism, and unstable global markets. I'm tired of riding the ups and downs of the market. It reminds me of 2008. I was caught off guard then. How do I prepare for the worst now? What'll I do if the dollar collapses?
You gotta stop worrying, son, and take action. It's time to think about a precious metals private storage IRA or an investment in silver with the Gold Silver Group. Like I said before, you insure your house, your car, your kids, and your life. Don't you think it's time to insure your wealth?
Call Gold Silver Group at 800-943-0834. Learn how easy it is to set up your own precious metals private storage IRA and how you can qualify for up to $700 in free silver. Gold Silver Group can satisfy any of your precious metals investment needs. Receive your gold and silver fully insured and privately delivered to your door. Call Gold Silver Group, 800-943-0834, 800-943-0834.
Right about now, you're tuned into
Young Men's Perspective Radio.
I be the Lord Finesse, a.k.a. the Underboss D.I.T.C.
on 1100Atlanta.com.
So keep it tuned right here.
We here now.
And we back, y'all. It's Young Men's Perspective Radio. I'm your host, Jeff Hodges. And online,
Digga Dame Lee, a.k.a. Paparazzi, the guy with the bionic eye.
And online, we about to get it in and let y'all know about that film, Hip Hop Film Festival with the founder, C.R. Caper, before we shut it down. C.R. Boogie.
Yes.
All right. So let them know where they can definitely get on board and all that so they can reach out to you guys.
So remember, guys, you're taking submissions now through May 15th. You can go to our website at hiphopfilmfestival.org. You can find all the information there. We're taking submissions through Film Freeway. You can call our offices at 347-574-0700. We'll take care of you. We're also taking volunteers again. All the information is on the site, everything you need, one-stop shop. We're on Facebook at Hip Hop Film Festival NYC, Instagram, Hip Hop Film Fest NYC.
Okay, let me ask you this. If they happen to miss this deadline date, is there still a way to communicate with y'all and be a part of the family movement, even though they may miss this particular deadline date? Like,
Definitely. Just hit us up. Send us an email, info@hiphopfilmfestival.org. Again, that's info@hiphopfilmfestival.org, or just call the offices, 347-574-0700. We'll take care of you. We try not to turn anybody away. Love is love.
Love is love.
So what's next, y'all? What's going on for the future? Tell us a little something we should be on the lookout for coming from your camp.
Glad you asked that question, because after this year, we're going to try to take it on a domestic tour and maybe hit an international spot. Mm. That means that we'll be bringing winners of the festival. We want to touch down in Atlanta. That's our number one spot that we're looking at coming to next.
We're going to have to link up when you come through. You come through Atlanta, you got to holler. We're going
to
make you real comfy.
Oh, you know. You already know. Okay. You already know we coming through. But we want to either hit the, we're going to hit domestically, you know, hitting the major hubs, Atlanta being the first, of course.
Okay.
And then we want to take it overseas. We want to go to Japan or the UK and then grow from there. So, and then with the streaming service, if somebody can't come to the festival or they miss us at one of the satellite locations, they got the streaming service. Go to hhfftv.com, sign up, it's all there.
Now, let me ask you this. How are y'all gaining funding to do a lot of the projects that's going on? And the reason why I'm asking, I just wanted to know, is there anyone over in that family tree that's dealing with Forex as far as a way to extract energy from that $5.3 trillion a day business over there? Like, is there a way, is there anyone doing that? And again, how are y'all raising funds to help facilitate?
Well, right now we're raising funds through sponsorship, ticket sales, you know, the usual when you throw an event. But sponsorships are key, and strategic partnerships are great. You know, last year we brought Netflix on board. We had, as a sponsor, we had Harlem Brewing Company. A lot of local businesses joined in the effort and supported financially to help us put it on. So, you know, we're doing that again this year. This year we got CBS on deck. A lot of our other older sponsors are still coming back. So that's what it is. And our community outreach, because we're doing it in Harlem, so we have to include the Harlem businesses as well. Mm-hmm. So, you know, if we put the economics into the community should give back the economics, and we create this cipher of financial stability amongst everybody so that we can thrive, the filmmakers can thrive, the businesses can thrive, the community thrive.
Creating our own Wall Street again.
Facts.
That's what's up. CR Boogie, it's definitely been a pleasure and honor. I salute you and your team for what you guys are doing over there. Yes. And got nothing but love for you and wish the best for you in the future. Before going, share with my listeners your closing remarks.
My closing remarks?
Your closing remarks.
Oh, okay. Well, my closing remarks is, first of all, what you guys are doing is crucial to promoting positivity and keeping the negativity at bay. So I want you guys to keep on keeping on. We are supporting you. We will always support you. And in closing, I would just say continue to find ways to change the narrative. Continue to find ways to push our stories out there or support those stories that are being pushed out there. Create our own media. Support our media. Support independent media. It is crucial and necessary, especially in these times that we are in now. It is important that we make sure that our stories are heard, that real news is gotten, and that we support it.
That's facts, man.
Indeed.
And we're going to make sure that we support that real fake media, because we go hard body with Young Men's Perspective Radio over here. Make sure that we get our sponsorship game up over here, because we got teams to work with, teams to build with. We got CR Caper in the building.
Hey.
And there's nothing but love for you. We thank you again for joining us. And again, we're looking for nothing but good things for you to go down in the future.
Thank you. Same to you guys.
All right. You have a good
night. Enjoy your night.
You're listening to Young Men's Perspective Radio. I'm your host, Jeff Hodges. That was our special guest, founder of the Hip Hop Film Festival in New York City, CR Capers. For me, it's Sha Boogie. That's that Harlem world. And we want to thank all our listeners for joining us. And we're looking forward to next week, y'all. We still going to keep it rolling. On deck, we got another founder of the black media, because as you know, we got the controlless narrative. Be joining us, Scotty Reed, founder of Black Talk Network. And we're going to learn all about his mission and what he's doing over there and keeping things going. And as she said, keeping that negativity at bay and bringing you that real informative information.
We want to say also, thank y'all for tuning in, man. Thank you for taking moments out of your day, this 1 hour, just to catch us aiming to project a form of light that's going to make sense to you. Something you should be able to build off of this plate right here. You understand what I'm saying? Like, you should be able to find some form of nourishment that's delectable to your palate's appetite. It's very important that y'all stay with us. Keep following us. We need them sponsorships. We need y'all to rock with us. You know what I mean? Like, be a part of this family team, because it's necessary. This is official, man.
All right, so once again, thank you for listening to Young Men's Perspective Radio. I'm your host, Jeff Hodges, with my co-host, Digga Dame, and we look forward to seeing you next week. Same time, same station. Have a good night, and peace, Atlanta.
Peace.
This is
Young Men's Perspective Radio, live on Iliad. We are real baby.
I love you guys.
Ladies and gentlemen,
you are listening to Young Men's Perspective Radio.
Live on Iliad, we are real baby.
We look to enrich, encourage, and engage our youth here on iHeartRadio.
And it's presented like a jewel.
We interview individuals such as Susan L. Taylor.
What we know is that failing schools are the pipeline to prison.
Jasari X.
We're the changers, and I feel like this generation is a generation that's really going to make change.
Dr. Julia Hare.
The best part of our action plan is to reclaim the minds of our children.
Dick Gregory.
Our problem is we think we part of this government, you know.
This is Young Men's Perspective Radio.
Live on Iliad, we are real baby.
Tune in to WWRN 1100 AM on Wednesdays from 3 to 4 p.m. and every Friday from 10 to 11 p.m. on WWE 1100 AM on iHeartRadio.
Just got to get in tune with your purpose.
YMP.
You know.
Your calling number is
404-603. 8770. Your host, Jeff Hodges.
We here now
with your co-host, Digger Dame Lee.
Young Men's Perspective Radio.
Young Men's Perspective Radio.
YMP.